Good afternoon, everyone. So I'm going to present on topic titled as GC-MS-MS analysis for the detection of pregabalin drug in biological specimen of a sexually assaulted victim. Thank you. Beginning with the introduction, the definition of DFC, that stands for drug facilitated crime, includes the commencement of an offense under the influence of a chemical substance, and the impacts of that chemical substance over an individual can be the impairment of the senses. It impedes the motor activity, cognition, and the memory of the individual with the outcome of distorted perception. There is an altered response to the stimuli, and most importantly, the decision-making ability of the person, the ability to give consent, and the amnesia is also reported. An incapacitating chemical substance is covertly given to the victim in combination with series of beverages like alcohol, water, tea, etc., in order to make an advantage or to harm the person in a non-resistible or unconscious state. Drug-facilitated sexual assault is a subcategory of DFC, and these included the offense in which the consent is not taken because the person is unable to give, and under the influence of the substance, sexual offense are committed. Please change the slide, ma'am. Now, this case study present a case of 32 years old female who was brought to hospital in New Delhi in an unconscious state. She was forcefully raped by her friends and under the influence of the substance administered to her covertly by dissolving in a cup of tea. The biological sample, that is blood, and the physical evidence procured from the crime scene were collected and forwarded to Chemical Division of Forensic Science Laboratory, New Delhi, for expert opinion. Please change the slide, ma'am. Thank you. Okay. So analytical methodology followed during the examination of the exhibit was deproteinization of the blood was first conducted, followed by extraction of suspected analyte. Then preliminary examination using TLC was done. Further, the confirmatory analysis was done using GC-MS, triple quad, that is GC-MS-MS, double MS, was used. So the results obtained were, during the preliminary examination, it indicated that the unknown drug capsule and the analyte extracted from the blood of the victim were same. And when the confirmatory analysis was conducted, it shows that both the exhibit contained the drug pregabalin. So the conclusion, through forensic examination, it is evident that pregabalin has abuse potential and is used for committing sexual offenses. As of today, this is the first case of sexual assault under the influences of drug pregabalin. I would like to mention here that even if we go through the literature, like cases of abuse and even the deaths were reported. But as of today, this is the first case of sexual assault under this drug. Pregabalin being sedative in nature, it is a sedative and is used in the treatment of various diseases like anxiety and and it also reduces the pain. And being sedative in nature, it becomes an effective choice to be used by the perpetrators. Please see in the slide, ma'am. Then coming to the significance. Now, this original research is of immense significance as this identifier and prescription drug, because to procure pregabalin, doctor prescription is required. And now it is a bit evident that these drugs are illicitly procured and misused in our country. As of today, the scientific community is unaware about its potential to get misused for committing specifically sexual offenses. So there is a high need for the research to be conducted for generating public awareness and scientific awareness so that more stringent regulation of this substance can be done. And this is very much relevant, I would like to mention, because pregabalin, though it is a prescription drug, it also falls under the category of designer drug. And designer drugs are those like within slight modification in the structure of parent, a series of analogs can be prepared with increased potency. So in order to curb the menace of drug abuse in our country, we need to conduct research studies over these substances and the possible analogs that can be prepared clandestinely. So And substantial amount of, also a substantial amount of data must be generated so that stringent regulation by the legal system of our country can be framed to control this substance abuse. Next slide, ma'am. So here are the, and thank you. That's all from my end.